I am pleased to announce that Dr. Squatch is the official soap of the professor. Dr. Squatch is the best-selling organic soap on the planet. Make sure you click on the link below to purchase your bar. Feel like a man, smell like a champion.
Well, welcome back to Movie Community College. I am the professor, and I am at the luxurious three-star Crowne Plaza hotel by the Phoenix Airport. The Warrior Queen is in with all of her homegirls. There's like 40 of them, and you may see them passing by as they come in and out of breaks. And I spent the night here, and have been enjoying my stay. I like the chair. I feel very kingly in this chair. I have a Carolina Goswami video. I apologize for the lighting. It's hard to find the lighting here because they do a lot of mood lighting, right? But hopefully it will do. And Carolina Goswami is doing a video here. First of all, let me just say, Carolina, I don't know if you know who we are. I don't mean to sound like that. Like, do you know who I am? Like, I don't know if you do, but we enjoy your videos. I think you do a good job on them. And this is the Indian Villager versus Sweden's Greta Thunberg. How dare you? The Shocking Reality by Carolina Goswami. And I know who this girl that she's referring. I don't know the Indian Villager, but I know the girl she's referring to because she's all over the American news. And she's Swedish, I think, and her parents are actors and very liberal activists. And from what I understand, this girl has autism. And so it's kind of, what I've seen of her is kind of a sad thing because it almost feels like she's being exploited to me. But what do I know? All right, let's go ahead and take a look at this.
Being an environmental activist appears to be the latest trend in Western nations. But our planet does not need more environmental activists. Actually, it just needs more individuals with a low ecological footprint. I should repeat this again. Our planet does not need more environmental activists. It just needs more individuals with a low ecological footprint. But what do we get? We get more and more environmental activists who themselves have a high individual ecological footprint. Through elite activism, we are definitely not going to save the planet from global warming. The planet can be saved only if we individually and collectively reduce our ecological footprint. Ecological footprint helps in understanding some lesser-known disturbing facts about Western nations, especially those nations which have more or less set the trends and the definition of an ideal lifestyle. So, can the world survive if we all follow the so-called ideal lifestyle of these Western nations? We all have read numerous media articles praising the so-called Scandinavian model when it comes to the environment. But when a major WWF study criticized Sweden for its unsustainable consumption of the planet's resources, did that news reach you too? The study revealed that if everyone lived the lifestyles that Swedes do, we would require 4.2 Earths. Did you know that if everyone in the world started to live like an average American, we would need 5 Earths? The ecological footprint comparison clearly shows that the average Indian is nowhere close to the average Westerner whose ecological footprint is many times higher. The average US household has 300,000 things. US children make up 3.7% of children on the planet, but have 47% of all toys and children's books. When it comes to a sustainable lifestyle, it should also be pointed out that even the average urban Indian outperforms the average urban Westerner. GreenDeck survey indicates that. According to the GreenDeck survey, India is one of the least wasteful economies. The survey also revealed that consumers in countries like Sweden, Britain, and Germany have been the worst offenders, but still they express the least guilt. On the other hand, Indian consumers live the most sustainable lifestyle. In spite of that, Indian consumers feel the guiltiest about their impact on the environment. And it is better if we avoid a discussion of historical emission, because the results can be too embarrassing for most Western nations. So, where did the problem start? In short, the answer is greed. In other words, the answer is work, earn and spend, the Western growth model, which is based on consumerism. Across the world, many countries are blindly adopting this. The biggest irony of our world is that we continue to seek solutions to reduce ecological footprint from the nations which themselves are the biggest offenders, while ignoring the low ecological footprint pre-existing traditional lifestyles in multiple Indian villages, which could easily become the global role models in so many ways. This is Parmadi in Jharkhand. Almost all farmers do organic farming in this village, and even the streetlights and stoves in the kitchen are run by solar power. The residents of this village are naturally happy and healthy. I wouldn't be surprised if the per capita ecological footprint of this Indian village turns out to be lower than the per capita ecological footprint of pet dogs and cats in America. The irony of our planet is that no one from such Indian villages, which have an admirable environmental friendly lifestyle model, gets an opportunity to be invited and talk at the most important global forums. In India, the concept of aparigraha has been an integral part of Dharmic societies for thousands of years. Aparigraha is about non-possessiveness and self-discipline, which means taking only what is absolutely necessary. The Western societies whose economies are based on greed-driven consumerism should learn that. Great sacrifices of Bishnoi community are very well known, and their heroic acts inspired many movements like Chipko and Apiko. Those were the types of environmental activists who deserve to be our global role models. Bhil tribes of Madhya Pradesh's Jabua and Alirajpur districts are using their age-old tradition, Halma, to conserve the environment. India's Ayurveda focuses on preventive healthcare and it encourages a vegetarian diet. It recommends the consumption of seasonal fruits and vegetables that are grown locally. Such practices save energy that is consumed in transportation. India's traditional system is all about reducing, reusing and recycling. In traditional Indian cuisine, leftovers are used to make mouth-watering nutritious dishes. Curd rice of South India, dal paratha of North India and khakra of Gujarat are a few examples. Sun drying is used to preserve food, and in Indian kitchens, using cloth instead of paper towels is a common traditional practice. Reusing old clothes to make new handbags and making a new fabric of khadi that uses very little water are some of the Indian traditional practices which have always been very gentle on nature. India's traditional knowledge has already inspired some Westerners. Leaf Republic of Germany is a good example. It sells biodegradable plates that are made of dried leaves. In many parts of India, these plates are known as pattal, and eating in them is just a normal traditional practice. An average citizen of many Western countries actively participates in the system that dumps e-waste in other countries and that outsources emissions to other countries. This is not a solution. Let us not forget that we are the very backbone of the economy that is based on the work and spend model. We help the system run by purchasing goods that hurt humans, animals and nature. Yes, we are involved. As long as we are greedy, self-indulgent and self-serving, there will never be a true environmental revolution. An inner revolution is needed to bring an environmental revolution, and that is why India's traditional knowledge is deeply interlinked with spirituality and inner well-being. Before I sign off today, let me leave you with an interesting fact. 327 million Americans own 163 million cats and dogs. These have a massive carbon footprint, as much of the food of dogs and cats is meat. If American pet cats and dogs had their own country, it would be fifth in the world for its consumption of meat. Meat production is known for its contribution to climate change. So, should Indians also go the American way? Or in terms of ecological footprint, can the world afford to go the Swedish way? See you again.
Well, I don't think I could disagree more with her, with Caroline Goswami. I think there is a Eastern Oriental way of thinking, and there is a Western way of thinking, and it is the Oriental versus Occidental. The cultures are different. The way we see things are different, and I don't falter for her point of view. But I think as far as global warming goes, in putting America as the culprit in that, I would say that's not true. It's not true at all. I don't believe in global warming. I think it is based on junk science. If you look at the history of it, there was manipulations done to the data to get to the outcome that they want. And I think what this is really about, the idea of shaming Western nations, is to slow down the American economy. It's a very popular tactic by the liberal politicians here in America to come up with carbon neutral or carbon taxes. So the more that you have, the more you pay to offset your carbon footprint, and then it goes into various programs. I think if you look at the history of climate, it is always changing. It is always changing. We had in Arizona one of our coldest winters ever. And I would say that the global warming community has changed their verbiage. They call it climate change now because climate warming's kind of has been disproven. The ice shelf is getting thicker with more ice, as opposed to what Al Gore said, I don't know, in the 80s. I think I've heard 3 or 4 times in my lifetime that in 12 years the Earth is going to be done, kaput, because of global warming. Now, is there pollution? Yes, there is pollution. What can we do about pollution? Well, we can do a lot about pollution. We can do a lot about pollution. America does do a lot about pollution. We have all kinds of mechanisms put on to manufacturing to recapture the emissions. And whether you think that's good or bad, I don't know. But I think if you're going to make a huge issue about pollution, I will tell you, I used to work at a chemical plant. This is what they used to teach us about pollution. The solution to pollution is dilution, right? Let's look at China. I kind of feel when I hear global warming, I feel it's like this. What about China? Someone going to go tell China. Go tell China to stop dumping, kryptonite into baby's milk or what. I mean, it's just so ridiculous when you look at China and what they spew into the atmosphere. So, good video, Carolina. She did some amazing footage. I don't know where she gets the footage at. And she does this great job, I think, of just where the camera kind of comes up on her and you kind of get a side shot or a back shot of her. And just really good. Really good video. She's one of my favorite YouTubers. So, can't wait to see in the comments how people say, you don't believe in global warming? No, I don't. I'll catch you guys later. Peace and much love.
Greetings. I am Minamoto Yoshitsune, #1 samurai in Japan. And I am here to greet you on behalf of Movie Community College. The professor and the warrior queen would like to ask you to subscribe to their channel, Movie Community College. They are close to 200k and they need your help. Please like and subscribe to Movie Community College or face the wrath of Japan's number one samurai.